Hi there, my name is Uncle Jesse, and I make videos all about 3D printing. Whether it's reviewing 3D printers or just making crazy nerdy things with them, I absolutely love these machines. But one thing I love even more than that is making extra money on the side by selling 3D prints over on Etsy. A little over a year ago, I made a video about how I made over $18,000 with 3D printing and selling things over on Etsy. If you haven't already seen that video, you'll find a link here in the corner. Make sure to go check that out after you finish watching this video. And today I want to talk with you about how I've now made over $30,000 by selling 3D printed things over on Etsy. That's right, I've almost doubled the amount of money that I've made in 1 year through my Etsy store. But I've paid over $14,000 in fees to Etsy. Yeah, that's a little crazy. So we'll take a deeper dive in looking into what are all involved with the fees and how some of those are really necessary fees that they're considering fees, while others, man oh man, I wish they didn't even exist. And towards the end of the video, I'll give you 4 additional tips on how you can make even more money with your 3D printers. So make sure, if you haven't already, to subscribe to the channel and make sure to like the video. It so helps with the algorithm here within the YouTube so that people like yourself find this video. I also want to take a quick minute to say thank you to today's video sponsor, which is Elgoo. They are the makers of the Elgoo Neptune 2 and the Elgoo Saturn, along with some other amazing resin 3D printers. The Elgoo Neptune 2 is one of the primary machines that I have been using over the last, 2 to 3 months now, since it was released, for almost all of my Etsy orders. This thing is such a beast, and if you can get your hands on it, it is a fantastic printer. Elgoo's also partnering up with Satori for a new upcoming Kickstarter campaign for a professional grade resin 3D printer. Really looking forward to more info on that machine in the upcoming weeks. You'll find links down below where you can find out more details on the Elgoo products featured in today's video. The whole concept for this video really kicked off just a few days ago when I received an email from Etsy letting me know that, hey, you've made over $10,000 in the past year, congratulations. And we're also lowering your advertising fees from 15% to 12%. What's really frustrating about this is that it's 15% or 12% on top of all of the other fees that Etsy's already charging me to actually have my store up and running. That includes the listing fees, relisting fees. So when an item's sold and it needs to be relisted on their site, there is fees for actually selling the item. Then there's actually fees associated to buying shipping labels through Etsy as well. So it all kind of compounds along with these now advertising fees that are being bundled in together. The only good news about the advertising fees are that you're only charged those if someone actually clicks on one of the ads that they've listed and buys your product from clicking on that link. So thankfully, I'm not actually paying for anything additional, but it's only when an actual sale is made. But it still hurts that additional fees are taken away from me and are going back to Etsy. So let's take a quick look at a summary of my site and some of the stats for the lifetime of my store. I've had over 160,000 people that have visited my shop. I've made over 1,800 sales, which is incredible. It's almost 2,000 sales that I've made through my Etsy shop. And I've made over $30,000. And again, that's 30K that's in my pocket. That's after all of the fees and all that other crazy stuff that comes out on Etsy's end. Now let's change the view and look at what I've currently made from the beginning of 2021 until May. So I've made $7,000. That's great. I've paid $2,300 in fees to Etsy. That's not all entirely clear because some of those are honestly justified fees. So here, let's get a breakdown of it. Under listings, this is where you can see all of those different listing fees, whether it's the actual listing itself or a renewal fee or the restocking fee that comes with someone's bought your order and it's now listed again up there. So I paid $46.20 when it comes to that. Now, when it comes to marketing, I've paid almost $100, so $96.86 in those off-site ads. Here's where it gets a little bit tricky because what they consider fees are all of the shipping that I've purchased. So this is technically something that I would have to pay for anyways, regardless of Etsy or not, when it comes to actually selling 3D printed things online. So I've paid back to Etsy $1,845.30 in shipping labels. So that to me really should be its own separate category, not something that's necessarily coming directly out of an Etsy fee. Then we also have our transaction fees. So here is a shipping label purchase fee. So they've got a shipping transaction fee of $55 I paid. So that's just for me to use Etsy as the platform for purchasing the shipping labels. I've paid $55. That's not great. And then there's a transaction fee on top of that. So anytime that they're taking the payment and processing that, there's $283 that I paid in those fees. So if I deduct the $1,845 of those shipping fees directly from the $2,327, we're really looking at $482 in fees that I paid to Etsy since the beginning of this year. If I look at a quick summary of last year, I made almost $10,000, which was great. It says I paid over $3,000 in fees, but again, a lot of that is the shipping charges. So $2,462 directly in those shipping label fees. If I subtract that from the $3,000, it comes out to really being $782 in fees that I've paid Etsy. So for the past year plus, I've paid over $1,000 in fees to Etsy just to use their platform for all of the sales. So that's $1,000 not going in my pocket, that's going into Etsy's pocket for using their platform. Whether I like it or not, that's how it's gonna work. It's all gonna come down to whether or not you want to pay those fees by using Etsy's platform or standing up something on your own or finding somewhere else to actually sell your products. For me, it's a little bit of a necessary evil just because of the items that I'm selling, and Etsy does such an amazing job of getting those in front of people so that I can actually make the sales, and I don't mind paying that bit of a cut back to Etsy for the amount of money that I'm making. However, I really wish those fees were a little bit less. That's a perfect segue for me to talk about our four tips on how you can make even more money, whether or not you're selling it on Etsy or somewhere else. The first tip I want to give you is setting up your own store. And I don't mean within Etsy. I'm talking about your own standalone website that you can actually sell goods through. This is an addition to your Etsy shop so that when people buy things from you off of your Etsy store, you can include information onto your own site where they can buy additional things or maybe other products that you're offering, even at a deeper discounted price than what they could find over on Etsy. The reason why I really recommend this is because recently I had some Etsy drama where they shut down my secondary shop for no reason whatsoever. We didn't violate any of their terms or issues, and they refused to answer any of our questions. And then out of the blue, they reinstated our store and said sorry and refused to explain anything further. I'll be releasing a follow-up video that'll detail all of the exact steps that I took to actually set that up and how you can do the same. After the experience that I recently went through, I honestly think this is an absolute must that everyone really needs to look into. Because at any point in time, Etsy can shut down your store without really any reason given. The second one might be a no-brainer, but promote your products. And I'm not talking about the Etsy ads. I'm talking about using social media to your advantage. And I know what you're thinking. This guy's talking to me. He has 100,000+ subscribers on YouTube. It's easy for him to say. Well, let me tell you, if you're not already on TikTok, you really should be. I follow and continuously see so many people producing and making amazing things that they're sharing over on their TikToks. And it doesn't have to be anything elaborate. It's just really quick go-to videos that they've made with their phone that are showing off their products or their day-to-day process or shipping out orders or showing off what the product can do. And they're getting tons of views and followers and building an audience to help support their business. I would really, really recommend that. It's such a simple way to get more eyes on your products and potentially get them to click on over to your shop. Make sure to try and tag me on some of your 3D printed products that you're selling, and I'll try to boost those as best I can over on that platform. This next one absolutely changed my life when it came to processing orders. And I ended up having to spend some money, but I'm saving a ton of money when it comes to actually printing my postage. I'm talking about a thermal printer. These things do not use ink. They're mind-blowingly amazing. You can basically buy different sheets of adhesive paper, and some of those are in the shapes of shipping labels, which is what I primarily use, but you can also use them to make stickers or other cool items for your different packaging needs when it comes to prepping things. And what that will end up doing is saving you a ton of money on having to buy ink refill cartridges for your printers. And yeah, I'm not talking 3D printers, I'm talking just typical printers that you print with paper on. I've spent so much money buying ink cartridge refills from Walmart for my printer. I could have easily bought like 6 of these thermal printers. I'll have a link down below to the thermal printer that I'm using, and it works fantastic. The last tip I wanted to give you is that if you're selling a raw 3D print to someone and they're intending on actually finishing it themselves, and by that I mean sanding, smoothing, painting, all that good stuff, try to include instructions on how you'd recommend actually finishing the product. This will help someone that has had no experience whatsoever with working with 3D printable objects and how they can go about finishing it without trying to figure it out on their own. I know that's a really basic one, but I have gotten a ton of positive feedback from people that have been really appreciative of the fact that I included some pretty detailed instructions on how you can finish these Loki crowns. So hopefully you enjoyed this video update on how I've made over $30,000 on selling things on Etsy. And if you did, make sure to leave me some comments down below and let me know what you'd like to see next from me here. And if you haven't already, consider subscribing. I really do appreciate that. I also have a Patreon that helps support the channel here. I recently just released a number of my resin 3D printing profiles and support settings that I typically use across all of my resin 3D printers for my patrons. And if you're already selling 3D printed things on Etsy and seeing success, let me know in the comments as well. Always interested to hear feedback from other people on how they've been successful with their shops. Hey, thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye now.